Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video to any of you guys having a Kia with automatic transmission, 6-speed transmission, and you need to add transmission fluid or check the transmission oil levels. Stay with us, we'll explain how to do that step by step. That 6-speed transmission has been used in most of the Kia vehicles from year 2009 to currently year 2022, with some minor differences depending on what size engine you have, so it can handle that specific torque and horsepower. But practically the design is about the same. How you check the oil level will be almost the same for all of them. Before we start, let me tell you a little bit about us. Every single car we get at the garage, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos. Why we do that? Simply because our mission at the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need in return, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, that way we can keep making these absolutely free videos for you. Now, if you need to buy transmission fluid, parts, transmission filters, anything like that, check out the link in the description of the video below. That's where we get all our tool supplies from for the really good price and quick shipping as well. So with that being said, that's the transmission right here. We have a video that explains how to drain it. You have the drain plug on the bottom. Now on top of the transmission right here, okay, let me see if I can actually remove that light. Okay, for that specific video, I'm going to turn, okay, this light here up so you can see a little bit better. But here on top, guys, okay, you have, that's the fuel plug that you need to remove. Okay, you can see with the ratchet just goes in there, just the ratchet itself, okay, and get it loose. It's plastic, make sure you don't over tighten that one later as well. It has an O-ring, so it may not come out easy by hand. Inspect the O-ring and replace it if you need to. Okay, that's what it looks like. Now, that transmission, when you drain it, guys, depending on how you drain it, if you just drain the oil drain plug, maybe you got about 3 to 4 quarts of transmission oil. If you remove the valve body, okay, and if you actually, let me see if it's better with the light or without the light. With the light, maybe better. If you drain the valve body, remove it, anything like that, probably will take more. The whole transmission holds about 7.1 quarts of oil or 6.7 liters, but you cannot drain all of it because you have in the torque converter, you still have in the transmission. So I'll recommend, guys, okay, to put about 4 to 5 quarts usually, and we'll explain how you're going to check the oil level after that. So we did 1 quart now, okay, and slowly add it, and now we're going to add more, okay, and we'll continue. So now we're adding, okay, this is our 4th quart now, okay, 4 liters that we're adding. And I'll explain what else you need to do. Next step, you gotta make sure that the car is outside, okay? If for some reason it's in the garage, you have to have the doors wide open, ventilation really good, but I will never recommend to start your car in the garage and let it run for a while. Take it outside on level ground, okay? It needs to be completely leveled. Once you do that, guys, what you need to do, you need to now go ahead and install the fuel plug first, okay, and just get this one tight. Make sure you don't over tighten this one. It's plastic, make sure you don't cross thread it, just start it by hand and then install it, okay, and get it tight with the ratchet. Perfect. Now you're gonna go get, okay, we're still waiting on some parts here, because we rebuild that engine and we're still waiting on a few more things. But the next step that you will need to do, okay, at that point, you can start your car, okay? Make sure it's leveled ground outside because you will need to let it run for a while. Let the car run to until it reaches about 60 degrees Celsius on the coolant, guys, or about 140 degrees, okay, Fahrenheit. And how you can check the coolant temperature, let me show you. If you want to check the coolant, the exact coolant temperature, you can use a scanner like that, SC301. It's pretty cheap, guys, and you can go through live data and you can see the coolant temperature sensor. It will say coolant, engine coolant temperature, ECT, under the live data, and you can check the exact temperature. Once you reach, guys, 60 degrees, what I'll recommend, okay, go through the shifter, make sure you hold the brake, okay, the brake and the emergency brake, and go through the shifter in reverse drive, go through every gear twice, okay, then return it to park, okay, return it to park. And what you need to do after that, okay, you need to go ahead and slowly remove the check, okay, the check plug right here, Okay, let's go ahead and remove that one. Okay, while the car is still in park, you're going to do that. And at that point, you're going to open the top and you're going to add slowly transmission fluid until you see it coming out of here dripping. The moment it starts dripping, steady practically, you just go ahead, close it, and you're ready to go. That's how you're going to check the transmission oil level. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.